In this video, we're going to go over the Assistance API from OpenAI. As you can see, the API is currently in beta. So just a note, it's possible that there's small things that I'm going to go over that may change a little bit by the time that you're watching this video. There also will be additional functionality built into the Assistance API in the future that isn't there now. Just as an example, right now through the Assistance API, you cannot use DALL-E 3, which is the image generation directly through the Assistance API. You have to use the image generation call, which is a different API call. So just little things like that, just keep in mind. But the structure of how you set up the Assistance API and how it all works should all be the same. So the Assistance API is essentially giving you the ability to build a chatbot in a simpler way than previously was available. It's also giving you the ability to add additional functionality into your chatbot, such as a code interpreter, retrieval, function calling, which I'll get into all of that and how that works a little bit later. If you're familiar with ChatGPT and the GPTs that ChatGPT is now allowing people to create. So these are the specialized chatbots that have the ability to access the internet and use code interpreter and things like that. This is basically OpenAI's way of giving developers the ability to build their own chatbots into their own applications. So the first thing I'm going to do is just go into the playground. So go to platform.openai and you want to log in if you don't have an account. So create an account and log in. All right, so we want to click on playground. So here we are in the playground. You want to make sure that you are on the assistance playground, not the chat playground. So I'm going to go back to assistance here. If you haven't created an assistant already in the playground, you're going to want to go to the top left and click create assistant. Otherwise, it should prompt you to create an assistant here on the top left. So we're going to create a new assistant. The assistant is basically a chatbot that we're creating. This is very similar to creating a GPT in ChatGPT, if you've done that before. The name of this, I'm going to have this be a productivity coach. So I'm just going to type that in for the name. The instructions, so this is where you're able to give your assistant just a little bit more knowledge about how it should respond. So for now, I can just keep it simple and say you are a productivity coach. And let's leave it at that for now in the instructions. In terms of the model, there's different models that we can use. The newest model here is going to be the best. This is GPT-4. It should say Turbo if you're watching this video later, unless they change the name. This is the cheaper, newer, most up-to-date model available right now. But there's also GPT-4 and then GPT-3.5. 3.5 is going to be the least expensive model and the quickest model. But again, they're constantly improving the models. So by the time you're watching this video, there might be a different model for you to use. And then tools are different functionality that you can add onto your assistant. So you can turn on code interpreter, for example. This is going to give the assistant the ability to read CSV files, for example, and analyze that data. You can add retrieval. This is the ability to upload files such as you could upload files such as documents, and then the assistant is going to intelligently look up those documents as needed. So you can turn one or both of those on. Functions, this isn't something that we're going to get into right now, but this is the ability to call different services such as anything that you want, other APIs. So this is an example of getting the weather, getting a stock price. There's really a lot that you can do with functions, but that's not something we're going to get into right now. And then finally, you can upload files to the assistant. And what this is going to do is give this assistant additional information to go off of. So just as an example, let's say that you had, a PDF that was all about productivity and how to be a good productivity coach, you could just upload that file, and then this productivity coach is going to use that information that you upload when it's responding to users. So these are different things that you do when you are setting up your assistant. So for now, I'm just gonna keep it simple. Productivity coach, you are a productivity coach. Let's just keep all of the tools off for now. We can always turn them back on later. And then let's go ahead and click save. So here we go. Now we've created an assistant, and what we can do is start chatting with it. So I can say hello, and we can add and run. So adding is when you add a message to the thread, and then running is when you get a response back. So here we go, we have a response, and it's specifically related to productivity. So that's how you set up an assistant. So we actually just created an assistant in our OpenAI account, and now we can use the playground to chat with it and test it out. You can clear it out. You can look at the logs to see the different API calls that are going on, which is all going to make sense as we get further into this video. And then see kind of interact with your assistant and tweak it as needed. The next thing that I'm going to talk about is the structure of an assistant and the different parts of an assistant and how they all work together. So here, OpenAI provides a diagram that I'm going to walk through. So on the left side here, you can see there is, first we have the actual assistant. So we have the assistant that we created. In this example, there is a personal finance bot. That is the assistant. So just like we just created an assistant for, as a productivity coach, there's this idea of an assistant. The assistant can talk to multiple people, can have different conversations, and it's just one assistant that we're creating. Then we have the concept of a thread. So a thread you can think of as a conversation. Each thread is going to have a list of messages attached to it, and each thread is independent. So one thread cannot talk to another thread. So the way that threads work is you'll create a thread and then you'll add messages to that thread. So this is a little bit different than the way that you may have created chatbots before using GPT-4, when essentially every time you call the API to get a response, you have to send all of the message history with that API call. In this case, we're just going to be adding messages. You're going to see later there's an API call to add messages to a thread, and we're going to add messages. And then the next step is to actually run the assistant. So what we're going to do when we run the assistant is we're going to take the thread, we're going to take the assistant, and we're going to run it. And then when you run it, the assistant is going to create a message as a response. And it will also potentially use tools such as the code interpreter to actually run data analysis or run additional functionality based on the messages that are in that assistant. So on a high level, that's how assistants work with assistants, threads, messages, and running those assistants. And it will all continue to make more sense as we continue to go through this and you actually build your own assistant. The last thing I'm going to do before we start actually building our own assistant is walk through step by step what you need to do in order to use the assistant's API. So what I'm talking through here visually is what we're actually going to be doing and building in Bubble next. So the first step is to actually create an assistant. Now, you can do this through the API, so you could programmatically through your app create assistants. You also can just create assistants through the playground like we just did. So during this tutorial, we're not going to create an assistant through the API. We're just going to use an assistant that we create through the playground, and I'll show you how to do that later. But the first step is to actually create the assistant. The next step is to create a thread. So a thread is a conversation, and each user can have multiple threads, but each thread is independent from each other. So think of a thread kind of like a conversation. Next, we're going to add messages to that thread. So we're going to do API calls to add a message. You can actually add multiple messages to a thread. before you get a response, depending on how you want to set up your app. But we're basically going to be adding or appending messages to the thread that we create, and those are going to be associated with the user that adds those messages. Next, we're going to run the assistant. Running the assistant is going to take all of the messages in that thread, and then it's going to take the assistant that we created in step one, and then it's going to actually give us a response. And if needed, it's going to use tools like I talked about before, like Code Interpreter, to actually help give it the response. So that's how it works on a high level. There's a lot more that goes into the actual API, which we will get into as we start building. But hopefully, now you understand how the API works for assistants in OpenAI and on a high level how it's structured. Because that's really important to understand before we actually start building in Bubble.